आई डिड नॉट एक्सप्लेन दैट टाइम. सो क्वेश्चन वाज स्ट्रिंग वाज इम्यूटेबल राइट, वी कैन नॉट चेंज दिस, बट आई एक्सप्लेन सम लाइक कॉन्स्टेंट राइट. सो इफ यू आर परफॉर्मिंग मल्टीपल ऑपरेशन, सो बेसिकली वॉट हियर वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, इन सेम ऑब्जेक्ट वी आर ट्राइंग टू कॉन्कैट राइट. सो दिस इज द एग्जिस्टिंग ऑब्जेक्ट, दिस ऑब्जेक्ट इज क्रिएटेड एंड दैट ऑब्जेक्ट इन दिस वेरिएबल, रेफरेंस्ड वेरिएबल, दिस ऑब्जेक्ट हियर वी आर ट्राइंग टू चेंज दिस वैल्यू. सो हियर इन द सेम ऑब्जेक्ट वी कैन नॉट चेंज योर ऑब्जेक्ट, बट वॉट यू कैन डू सेम थिंग दिस वन इफ यू विल ट्राई टू स्टोर इन द डिफरेंट वेरिएबल एस वन, देन वॉट हैपन अगेन दैट रूल विल कम कॉन्स्टेंट, वन ऑब्जेक्ट विल बी क्रिएटेड इन एस ए पी एंड एट द रन टाइम वॉट विल हैपन, दिस ऑब्जेक्ट विल बी चेंज, मीन्स इट विल कॉन्कैट दैट. सो इफ यू विल नॉट स्टोर वॉट एवर द ऑपरेशन यू आर ट्राइंग टू चेंज, लाइक आई एम डूइंग द कॉन्कैट, इन एग्जिस्टिंग ऑब्जेक्ट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू चेंज. ओके, सो दैट्स वाई इट इज यू नो इट इज डिस्प्लेइंग जावा ओनली. बट इफ यू विल स्टोर दिस ऑपरेशन इन द डिफरेंट वेरिएबल, द एट द रन टाइम इट विल चेंज राइट, इट विल दिस कॉन्स्टेंट विल क्रिएट इन योर एस ए पी एरिया एंड रन टाइम आफ्टर कॉन्कैटिंग दिस इट विल स्टोर इन साइड दिस हीप एरिया विथ न्यू ऑब्जेक्ट. आई डिड नॉट डिस्प्ले एस वन, सो इफ आई विल डिस्प्ले दिस एस वन नाउ. ओके, सो सेम थिंग वी वर डूइंग इन द लास्ट क्लास एस वन, गॉट इट राइट. सो दिस वॉज द योर डाउट इन द लास्ट क्लास. अंकुर आर यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड? ओके, गॉट इट ना. ओके, सो बी हैविंग द कंस्ट्रक्टर, सो इन अ स्ट्रिंग बी हैव अ मेनी कंस्ट्रक्टर. इफ यू विल गो इन द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, ऑफिशियल डॉक्यूमेंटेशन विथ अ स्ट्रिंग, सो यू कैन गो थ्रू दैट जावा डॉक्यूमेंटेशन. और सो बी हैविंग द मैनी, लेट्स सी दिस इज वन, यस. सो इफ यू विल गो हियर अ स्ट्रिंग, सो हियर वी हैव अ स्ट्रिंग, इनसाइड दिस बी हैविंग द मल्टीपल कंस्ट्रक्टर. ओके, सो दिस आर द लिस्ट ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्टर अ स्ट्रिंग एंड सो मैनी कंस्ट्रक्टर आर देर, बट आई विल शो यू फ्यू कंस्ट्रक्टर. सो हियर दिस इज द लिस्ट ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्टर, हियर दिस इज द लिस्ट ऑफ मेथड्स, वॉट एवर द मेथड्स विच इज अवेलेबल इन साइड दिस स्ट्रिंग, वी हैव अ ह्यूज लिस्ट. ओके, वॉट एवर द इम्पॉर्टेंट वन वी विल डिस्कस, एंड आई ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड टू लिंक्स राइट फॉर योर प्रैक्टिस पर्पस. आफ्टर दैट यू कैन डू द प्रैक्टिस फॉर यू नो दिस all these methods. Okay, so it will very helpful for your real time or your interview a string chapter. Okay, so this is the one constructor, create an empty string. This is the second constructor, you can pass your literal also. This is your third constructor, you can pass the string buffer. So next topic is your string buffer only. Here we can pass the character and we can convert into the string type. So this is the one example. You can just copy this and you can paste it. So this is the char type of an array. Did I teach array in your batch? Array concept? No, right? Okay. So I will teach you. Okay, I will again go through that what I have covered. Okay, so this is your char type of an array. So array, if I will go through that array, we having the many things. So just you can understand this is your one dimensional array and type is your char. This is your referenced variable. Why we use an array? If you want to store multiple elements in a single variable, then we should go for array. Array means we have a requirement for 100 a value or element you have to store. We cannot write int a equal to 10, right? Int b equal to 20, like 100 times, right? So we have a one concept called an array. So inside this array, we have a single referenced variable. We can store multiple type of, you know, element. But we have some limitation of an array. What is the limitation? Size is fixed. So here, you can store as per the how much required. If you will create an array, internally array is like int a equal to new. So this is the another inbuilt syntax is there. But if you will go in array, so this is like that. So I've given the size 5 here. So here size 5. So here after that you can store the value a of 0 equal to 1 something. A of 0 equal to 1. Okay, like that. So what happened? This is your type. Which type it is? Integer type. This is your array, one dimensional array. Symbol this is your referenced variable. New keyword means what will happen? One object will be created. So here what happened? When you are writing new keyword, one object will be created. Inside this object we have this location. So it is your location. This location is depend upon how much size you have given here. So we have a integer value. So by default, this integer value will store here. 0, start with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so start with 0 index. Now, if you are writing a of 0, 1, so it will store here. In place of 0, it will store here. So this is the internal structure of an array. I will discuss. Many things are there, two dimensional array and all, so I will discuss on that. So this is like same, this char, this syntax is also same. Internally what will happen, this object will create it and value is going to store like that. Okay, so this char type we are going to convert into the a string value. Means char type of an array we will get in a string. Okay, so by using this constructor. Okay, so we have a multiple methods here. So first method is your char at. Char at means, and it will pass here the parameter is index type, right? So here I'll show you. So char at means we will get where this index. As per index, we will get character value. So here index will start from 0, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3. The value will come 3 here, right? Here the it will start from 0 index. It is working. Caret is working at a indexing concept. So here index is 3. So here the index is what? 0, 1, 2, 3. Then a value will come. You can change this index value like 2. Okay, so v is coming, right? So it is working like that. If you will try to give like index 30 is not there, right? We will compile this code, it will work file, but at a runtime we will get exception, a string index auto want exception, because this is not, this range is not available whatever you have given the string, right? This range is not there, so we will get this string index auto bond exception. Okay, this is the another. So we have a concat. How to do the concat? So we have a concat method. So we already seen that this, and here we have this. This concept is called overloaded. So let's see that. So by using this plus operator, also we can concat this string. How to concat this? So we have a concat method, right? We have a concat method. So we already know. See, again, I am storing in this referenced variable. So what happened? It at a runtime it will concat this. By using this plus operator, we can also concat. See, now going to concat this all. Okay, so we can concat this one and this one. This format both are same. Okay, so just don't confuse this. Okay, so I'm going to concat all this value. You will get many example like that. I have shared my datring link, right? So we'll get many example like that. Okay, so we are concatting by using this plus operator. Okay, so this is, you know, how to concat the string. So we have a one method called equal ignore case. Equal ignore case to compare content where case is not important. Here, what is the difference between equal and equal ignore case? So here, case doesn't matter. Like this is the small, a small Java. All the character is a small. Here all the character is capital, right? So if you will use this equal method, then what happen? It will get false. But if I will use this equals ignore case, then what happen? It will ignore this case. Okay, so this is the difference between equals and equal ignore case. So value is coming true. This is your another method that is called substring. Okay, so return substring from being index to int index of a string. So this theory you want to understand will come on this example. So you will get, so we have a two types of the method for substring. One parameter, and here we are passing second parameter. So here where you are starting the index and where you are ending the index. Ending the index means int minus 1. Your a string, they will get the value where your string is ending minus 1. So let's see what I want to tell you here. So being index here. Okay, so being index starting from this. Okay, so here. This is your 0, 1, 2, right, being index. Apart from that, all the value will come. Got it right? So, better, if you will go the theory, you will get many confusion. You can change this, now the value is coming DEF, right? I'm going to change this index value. So, let's see what the output will come. 0, 1, 2. This. Okay. You can change again. 1. So like that you can explore all the methods. Changing the value and you can understand, right? Why how this output it is coming. This is the first one. Second one you can see. It is starting from 2. 0, 1, 2, int minus 1. Okay, so int minus 1 means 0, 1, 2. Or you can, what you can do, how can we can get this output? Just you can, also you can minus 3. So starting from 0, 1, 2, this is your, and you can see, if you will minus this, so we will get this string also. Or 0, 1, 2, a starting index, int minus 1. So int minus 1 here the value is coming 5, right? So 5 minus 1, it will go till 4. Got it right? So let's execute this. So this is coming CDE. सो अ स्टार्टिंग वैल्यू 0 1 2, ओके, इट विल गो टिल 5, 5 माइनस 1, इफ यू विल गो लाइक द कॉन्सेप्ट इट विल गो टिल 4, राइट. सो दिस इज कमिंग, यू कैन चेंज दिस वैल्यू. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डू 4, राइट. सो वॉट विल वैल्यू विल कम. सो 4, वट एवर द वैल्यू, 0 1 2 3 4, ओके, सो अगेन 4 माइनस 1, इट विल गो टिल 3, अ स्टार्टिंग वैल्यू इंड -1, सो इट वी आर गेटिंग सी एंड डी, ओके. सो दिस इज योर 4, यू कैन सी इट विल कम टिल 4 माइनस 1, सो इट विल गो लाइक यू नो दिस वैल्यू इंड -1, ओके. सो लाइक दैट यू कैन डू द मल्टीपल मल्टीपल टाइम्स द प्रैक्टिस, यू विल गेट इट सब अ स्ट्रिंग, ओके. सो दिस इज योर 1. Another method is called length method. So we have a one more question. What is the difference between length variable and length method? So length is your method and length is your variable also. In Java, in array, we will use length variable by finding the length of the array. So here we have a length. So we will get the length of the string. Okay, so we are getting 5, but here length is your variable. By using this length, we can find the size of an array. So this is your 5. I'm giving the 5 size, and here we can use this. Okay, so here we will get array size. Here we will get a string size. Got it, right? So this is the difference between the length method. This parenthesis is not there in variable, length variable, right? So this is your interview. Yes. Here. Yeah. Okay. Got it, right? So this is the one question, is there length variable and length method. Okay. So return type is integer type. Okay. So here that's why we can minus any integer value, right? Return type. If you will go in this, you can see we will understand. Okay. So what is the return type? Integer. So we can also play with integer value. Return the length of the string. So it depend upon your, you know, which type it is. Got it, right? Okay, so it is the integer type. So definitely we will, we can minus the integer value. If you will try to perform the another, like you will use 1.5. I think it will also work. Okay, why? Because the integer or float, it will come inside this calculation part. So it is also working. Or you can give like any a string value. So a string, it will say this is like binary operator, something is, you know, bad operator it is coming like. So you can see that integer type, first type is int, second type is a string. That float is coming inside this data type like integer type, right? So floating value we can also perform here. Got it, right? So you can, whatever in your question will come, try to do on your system, and we have to think why it is coming this. Got it, right? Okay, so like that you can explore. So length variable applicable for array, not arrays. Arrays is another class, array, but not for a string object, where the length method applicable for a string object, but not for array, not arrays, this is array. Okay, So this is the one another method is called replace method. So this replace method will replace the string value. So if you will go in the replace, so what you want to replace? This in place of A, I want to replace B. Okay. So all the A value will replaced by B. This is your another method. So we have a lower case and upper case. So I will give you that example later. So what will happen? It will upper case, it will convert into the lower case, and lower case, it will convert into the upper case. We have a trim method. So trim method will, it will remove the blank. Okay, if in the real time, you have to compare actual and expected, right? So what happens sometime, we having the space of that string, right? So we need to remove this trim. If some space is there, actual and expected, then what happened? Some of the space were there. What we can do? We can trim that. So a space will be removed. Okay. It removed, right? The middle of this. So we have another method called return the index of the first occurrence, index of. So here it will return the index value. Okay. So it will return the index value. So what is the index value of G? It will return. Okay, so it is returning 012, this value. So this is your index of. So last index of, so here we will get last index value. So here you can learn something. So here we will get last index of. So here we know index of. So it will return 0. Here it will return last of the index. So this is the difference between index of and last index of. So we are getting last value. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Got it, right? So this is your index and index of. So we have a replace all. One more method is there. Replace all. Okay. So it will replace a value with a. It will replace all this with the S. Replace and replace all, it is like the same. Okay, can see there is no too much difference between replace and replace all. Okay, so we have another one more concept, like what we have learned with two concept, right, last time. So this is also important, so we will understand this. And this is also a little bit having the confusion, but we will do R&D on that. Okay, so here what is this? Because of runtime means when JVM executed your code, if there is a changes in the content, any changes is there in the content, then those changes, a new object will be created in heap area. Okay, so if anything will go get change here, this content object, one new object will be created in heap area. If there is no changes in the content, then existing object will be reused on the new object, won't be created, whether the object present in heap area or SAP area, rules is same. Okay, so we already know that, right? So any new object will be created, then content will change, one object will be created, but you have to remember, might be this object changing in SAP area, then new object will be created in heap area only. Okay, so let's see this one example, we will get more clarity here. So here same, we will go in paint. So we have a heap area and SAP area, right? We have a heap and SAP. Oh shit, it's increased too much. Okay, leave it 100, no problem. Okay, so here you have a heap area and SAP area. दिस इज योर हिप एंड दिस इज योर एसएपी. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट हैपन, वी हैव अ ऑब्जेक्ट एस वन, देन ब्लाइंडली टू ऑब्जेक्ट विल क्रिएटेड. राइट, दिस इज वन ऑब्जेक्ट एंड दिस इज योर अनदर ऑब्जेक्ट. दिस इज हैविंग योर जावा and this is also having the Java. And here, why, what we are going to do, this is your S1, it will point S1 as per what we have learned in the last time. Now I'm going to change this content. So we have a lowercase and we have a method called uppercase, to uppercase, then object will be changed, right? To uppercase, object will be changed. So here the object will change. Here I told you, right, if any changes is there, then object will be, new object will be created in heap area. So this is your capital Java. It will point here S2. Here it will point S2, right? Any changes is there, then new object will be created in heap area. Again you can see S1 dot lowercase, S1 dot lowercase, any changes is there, S1 is already having the lowercase, no changes is there. So same S3 will point for same object, there is no object will be created. Okay, so here you can go here S1 dot lowercase, right? So now if you will compare S1 equal to S3, S1 or S3, you can see we are comparing S1 or S3. Once again, what is comparing this? Sorry, first one is S1 and S2. S1 and S2. So here we have to understand. Okay, so this is, you know, I will tell you in this example, you won't get what actually I want to tell you. Hash code is different for every object, we already know. This is having the hash code of 01 and this is having the hash code of 011, right? So this is the object, you know, object having, every object having the hash code. Here I am going to compare with double equal operator, right? Here comparing with double equal operator, you can see S1 equal to S3. S1 equal to S3 means it is pointing, it is comparing same hash code, that's why the value will come true. Here the value will come false. Content is also, if you will use the equals method, so content is also what, different than S1 equal to S2 will come false and S1 equal to S2 will come true. In both case, if you will compare with double equal operator or if you will compare with equals method also, in both case it will come true. Got it, right? So if you will, you can see false and true. Okay, so this is the one example. Same example I'm going to explain you for your practice purpose, then I have another example for that. So let's see. So whatever the rules is there, then we will stick with same rules. Okay, so again I'm going to open new paint here. I will open new paint, don't save. Okay, so now we have a SAP area and we have a heap area. So this is your SAP and this is your heap. Okay, so now, oh sorry, okay, I will confuse. So better to we cannot change this. I'm writing here heap always. So if I will do right and left, it's very confusion topic. So better to write heap here and SAP here. Okay, so now what I can do, same first line of the code, same what we know already. So one object will be created in heap and one object will be created in SAP. So here we have a Java and here we have a Java. Okay, so this is S1. S1 will point here. That's it. This is the first line of the code we have done. You can see S1 dot uppercase. Yes, content is going to change. Then object will create in heap area only. Yes, so here we have a capital Java. So here we will write change this. Oh, capital Java, right? This is, and what is the referenced variable? Referenced variable is S2. So S2 will point here. S2 will point here. S2 will point here. This is, now what is the next line of the code? S1 dot lowercase. S1 is going to change this content? No, it is not going to change. Then what will happen? Same object we will use here. Then S3 will point here. That is S3, right? S3. Yes, this is S3. S3 will point same object. Now, what is the next? So again, S2 dot lowercase. This one I have done. So S2 is already uppercase, right? So content is going to change. Then what happened? Object. Always, if any content is going to change, then object will be created in heap area. Either the content will change in the SAP also, the object will content in the object will create in the heap area. So what I'm going to do, this S2 converting into the lowercase now. This one done, right? S2. So S2 converting into the lowercase. So where is this pen? So here Java. Okay, so now it is pointing to variable. What is this variable name? S4. It is pointing the variable name S4. So this is your S4. Sorry. This will go here and this is your S4 now. Again, anything going to change? Yes, again see, S4 again going to convert into the uppercase. So this content again going to change. Then again new object will be point. So this is lowercase converted into the uppercase. Oh, okay. So Java. Okay, so it will point S5. It will point S5. Now, the twist will come here. So we can see here, S1 equal to S3. S1 equal to S3. This is your double equal operator, right? S3 and S4. We are comparing S3 and S4. S3 and S4. What the output will come? It will come true or it will come false. Here, what the output will come? S3 and S4. If you will understand this concept, then you can play with a string. True? But you have to see what I am going to compare. It will come false, right? Because this is the double equal operator. We are not comparing with content. So I told you, right? ऑब्जेक्ट हैविंग द वन यूनिक हैश कोड. वेयर इज दिस? दिस इज द यूनिक हैश कोड 001 एंड दिस इज हैविंग द कोड 011. सो इट इज नॉट कंपेयरिंग दिस कंटेंट, इट इज कंपेयरिंग हैश कोड. सो दैट इज यू नो एवरी टाइम द इंटरव्यूअर विल ट्राई टू कंफ्यूज यू यूजिंग हैश कोड, सॉरी डबल इक्वल ऑपरेटर एंड इक्वल ऑपरेटर, सॉरी डबल इक्वल ऑपरेटर एंड इक्वल्स मेथड. इफ यू यस 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 ऑलवेज यस. सो नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू कंपेयर एस टू डबल इक्वल एस टू एंड एस थ्री. सो एस टू एंड एस थ्री, सो एस टू एंड एस थ्री, सो इट विल ऑल्सो कम फॉल्स, राइट? ऑलवेज कॉल फॉल्स. हियर अगेन द हैश कोड इज योर 012. दिस इज द डिफरेंट हैश कोड. इफ यू विल कंपेयर डबल इक्वल ऑल्सो देन कम फॉल्स एंड योर डबल इक्वल ऑपरेटर एंड इक्वल्स मेथड ऑल्सो इट विल कम फॉल्स बिकॉज द कंटेंट आर different, right? Both content are also different and here hash code is also different, so this is also come false. S2 and S3, and if you will compare with S5 and S3, so S5 and S3, this is your S3 and S5, same you can see previous concept. Okay, it will also come false because both having the different object. So here the hash code is 013. If you will compare now, the what is the output will come? Here what the output will come? S1 equal to S3. You can see S1 and S3 pointing same object, right? You can see same object it is pointing. This one is pointing same object. So hash code is same for both, right? So the value will come true. You can execute first and compare this. Are you able to understand this concept? If you have a doubt, let me know. Salini, are you able to understand?
Yes.
Yeah, just I have added this. Okay, so I have added to show you in which condition it will come true. It is pointing the same object. Same object means only one hash code is there. Okay, so we have a one more code, so you can see the proof of that. But we having the many confusion for that. Okay, I'll show you this code, but here. Same like okay, so what was the confusion? I'll tell you. If you will try to print system.out.println, okay, so here okay, this is the object I was trying to print this, and sometime you cannot able to execute get the hash code, proper hash code. So this is your S1 and I'm trying to print this S2. You can see every condition the value will coming the java only. Even hash code I was printing, it is coming java. And here if you are comparing double equal operator with s1 equal to equal to s2, then value is coming false. Got it right. What is the confusion? So we have a one method call identity hash code s2, one of the she want to join my session, and she is searching my engineers tech hub on the Google, and she was telling I am not able to find your office. Okay, so this is your identity hash code. So by using this identity hash code in Java, you will get many library are there. So now we will find this solution why this is coming false. But here if we will I try to print the object also, the Java is coming. I try to print reference variable also, Java is coming. Then question will come why it is coming false. So whatever the concept is there, we were stick with that. So someone will ask, can you show me the how it is coming? I need to show. So this is one more method is there. If you are not able to display your hash code, so one more method is there in the system class. System is your inbuilt class. Inside the system class we have a method called identity hash code. So this will not help you in your Selenium, but definitely as a concept wise you are very good in the core Java. You can play with anything, and logical part you can do slowly, then after that you can, after 1 and 2 year, you can acquire another programming language, that is Python. So that Python will also very easy if you know the Java. In Python everything is an object. If you are writing a equal to 10 also, that one object will be created and value we will store inside this object. Okay, so it's very easy to acquire another language, and we need to at least you having that minimum 2 programming language. So leave it, that is the your future, but present we can switch the company, you will get the job, and you can work at least 1 and 2 year, then you can start with another. So this is also this is like same. So this diagram we need to understand. Okay, so I will ask to you guys where the object will created, then I will guide you. In a string concept, you won't be stuck anywhere. Okay, in interview also, just do the practice for all this code SAP. Okay, so now where the object will be created, this line in hype area or SAP area? This is a string literals, right? Yes, this is a string literals. So object will be created in SAP only. Okay, so this is your small Java, and it will point, this is S1, right? So S1 will point here. S1 will point in my system. Sometime internet is not working, sometime it is working, and right now I can't do anything, that is the problem. So I try to uninstall that and again install that, so it is working fine and it is good. I was wondering how to take the session today. Now we can see again I am calling to a string means right, what is the to a string? If you will call the to a string, it will represent only a string part, right? There is no content change. Then S2 will also point here. If there is no content, means this string value will not change, same object will be point. Okay, so here, if you will call, if you will print this value, S2, you can get same output, You can get same output here. This true is coming for what? Okay, this is coming here, this value. Okay, see, right, to a string means we are not doing anything, just printing this, calling this to a string. So that's why this value is coming here. It is pointing same object. Now s1 dot lowercase, are you going to change this content? No, lowercase already there. Then this, there is no object will be created. S3 will also point in the same object. No object created. I'm trying to change this object. S2 dot uppercase. So S2 is your what? This object only, right? S2 is pointing, but object is going to change. Then object will be created in heap area. This is your uppercase, right? This is your uppercase. Object is, if object will change, okay, so this is your capital Java and the reference variable is 4, so it will point. So just this example for your diagram, how this diagram is. So S4, again you are going to change this object, yes, lowercase, again I am going to do lowercase, then again one new object will be created, this is your lowercase. Okay, so Java, sorry, Java, and S5 will point here. S5 will point here. Okay, so this will point here. So this is, you know, how to work with a string concept and few of the code I have given to you. So tomorrow I will start a string buffer. So this concept is very important. All the code you can do the practice side by side, and you can find the logical code on the string, and you can work with data string. Okay, because a string is very important for your real working also. So we have to extract the, you know, in the real time what you have to do. In web page is there, right? So we having the many scenario will get a string, you know. You have to compare actual and expected. Might be some of the part of the string you have to extract. Okay, you need to, only you have to complete a string is there, but you have to compare few middle of the string, like that you in the real time you will get the scenario. Okay, so going to a stop, just do the practice. So a string